that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Good morning to you. It is 4 a.m. on this Friday. It's June 4th, and here are today's top headlines. There's contentious debate over wearing masks in the workplace. While you may need to wear them just a little while longer, that's even if you're fully vaccinated.
And cocktails to go and outdoor dining here to stay, the big boost for California restaurants.
And an L.A. County exodus, why more Angelenos say they're planning to move away in the next year. The early edition of the KTLA 5 Morning News starts right now. How many times are we going to have to say this morning? Don't adjust your TVs. It's not Saturday morning.
You didn't miss a whole
day. Yeah, you're not dreaming. It is Friday. Good morning, everybody. I'm Mark Mester. I'm in for Chris Schauble.
And I'm Lynette Romero in today for Megan Henderson. It's going to be a long weekend for us.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Working hard. And, of course, Ginger Chan's working hard, checking on our roads. And the hardest working man, he's working so hard he had to take his tie off, Henry DiCarlo.
Wow, you know, I've never heard anybody say that. Thank you very much.
Whoopsie.
Listen, I'm the new one here.
You should have heard what he said.
It's because you don't have your tie on, maybe.
Maybe that's it.
Right?
Exactly.
Ooh, you got the excellence bug behind you.
Oh, no.
Oh, man, look at that.
Already at 4:01.
See, am I missing something? Why is everyone being so nice to me? I'm not used to this. Usually they come right out of the gate and they're just throwing barbs at me. I like you guys. Thank you. You know, Kirk Hawkins is going to be working for Mark Criskey today. He should have just done it.
He should start working more. He's not working enough.
He's not working enough, but he could have done a double today. I mean,
except for he worked last night.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he did the night show because, yeah, I watched it in the morning, but yeah.
He loves it, though.
Yeah.
I'm surprised he just didn't spend the night.
Maybe he's around the corner.
Maybe he's
here.
Sleeping somewhere near.
Is that him yawning?
He might be. Anyway, good morning, everyone. Coastal temperatures are going to be in the mid to upper 60s today. Downtown 77. Today will be the warmest day in some spots. It looks like downtown it will be. And we're looking at some lower 90s in the Inland Empire today. We do have some wind gusts upwards of about 25 to 40, Ginger. So we'll talk about that.
Hey, go, Kirk. Get out. Oh, what?
he's hanging out. With you,
he's
huh?
rolling up his mattress and cot right now and trying to get me to get him some coffee. No, we will welcome him later on. That is a surprise, but a nice one. Yes, he probably is the hardest working person in general, right? Hey, good morning to you guys. Good morning, everybody. So we have a couple of things, man. We got to break these down for you, right? 710 freeway, that northbound side right here at Del Amo Boulevard. So it was a pretty serious crash. Just happened after 3 o'clock this morning. So they are calling this one to be a fatal. You see those delays, but what they're doing is they're taking everybody off at Del Amo Boulevard, and then they've got that on-ramp shut down as well. So there's some guardrail that was damaged. I mean, if you want to, you know, you can continue and stay on the stretch of the 710 freeway. If you exit at Del Amo Boulevard, you're gonna have to work your way around. You can always take that 405 freeway as well to get yourself around it. So there's a lot of different opportunities, but for now anyway, you've got to know that Siglett will be here till at least 5:30. This one, they are talking about police activity, 105 West at Vermont. The nature of this police activity means it could wrap up in 5 minutes. It could be here for the next 5 hours. So we'll just have to watch to see what develops. At least your drive is still pretty good both directions of the stretch of the Glen Anderson freeway. We'll keep our eyes on both these things for everybody. Gonna take a little while, Gacy, Lynette, Mark, back to you two for today.
It's okay, we got a few hours, we'll give it a try. All right, it is 4:03 on this Friday. A Cal OSHA panel has agreed to allow people to go maskless in the workplace. That's only if every worker is fully vaccinated against the coronavirus.
The decision leaves people wondering, how will workplaces carry out the new policy? KTLA 5's Alina Bovian is live now in Glendale with more of the details. Alina, good morning.
Good morning, guys. Well, the Cal OSHA board, they met yesterday, and this was a very long meeting. They talked for hours. They went back and forth. It was open.